friends, welcome to CYAS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So currently we have 12 series that focus on your prelims and one series that target your mains. So what we do in these prelims oriented series, we have basically divided your whole syllabus into 12 large subtopics, and what we do, we daily cover 2 subtopics, and in this manner in 6 days all your 12 subtopics are covered by us on this channel. So this process goes on and on in a cyclic manner, and we will continue to do so till 31st May. Why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC CSE 2019, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So let's start our discussion. So today is lecture number 56 of environment. So let's see what are the MCQs of today. Today's lecture, the first question is, the GIPCO movement was launched against A. Untouchability, B. Environmental conservation, C. Globalization, D. Commercialization of even basic services. So friends, it is quite easy question. So answer is B, environmental conservation. So it was a kind of organized resistance against the destruction of forest that spread throughout the India. So no name of movement comes from word embrace, as the villagers hugged the trees and prevented the contractors from felling them. So with encouragement of a local NGO, that is Dusoli Gram Swarajya Sangh, the women of the area under the leadership of an activist, Chandi Prashad Bhatt, went into the forest and formed a circle around the trees preventing the men from cutting the trees down. So this became a type of precedent to be followed world over. So this is the first question. Let's move on to the second question. The second question is, mangrove forests have reached a critical stage of decline in many parts of the world. Which of these have caused the gravest threat to mangroves? First, destruction of coral reefs. Second, fresh water diversion away from seas and oceans due to hydraulic structures. So we have to choose the correct statement, that which of the above statement is correct. Let me tell you friends that both of these are responsible for the destruction of mangroves. So basically, when the coral reefs are destructed, the strong waves which will strike with a much force with the mangroves, they have the potential to wash off the sediment as well as the important nutrients which can hinder the seed to sprout. So that's why mangroves do not have that much of consolidated roots in case sediment is not there. So destruction of coral reefs is responsible for it, and also fresh water diversion is also responsible, because the mangroves cannot survive in too much saline water. Though they exist in saline water, but the salinity must be to an extent. After that, it becomes difficult for them to sustain themselves in the highly saline water. So both of these are responsible. So the answer would be C. So the solution is C. So friends, we provide the explanation of only first question. In case you want the explanation of all the questions, then you can email us at this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com, or you can contact us at our WhatsApp number, that is 8968426481. So friends, there is a minimum cost that is associated with this explanation PDFs. So in case you want to subscribe, you have to pay a minimum amount that has been kept as low as possible for the purpose of your affordability as well as for the purpose of our motivation. So let's move on to the next question. The third question is, consider the following about the Commission for Conservation of Antarctic Marine Living Resources. First, it is a part of Antarctic Treaty System. Second, it was established to protect krill resources, which are keystone component of Antarctic ecosystem. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you friends that both of these are correct. That is, it is part of Antarctic Treaty System, and also it is established to protect krill resources. So the answer would be C. That is both 1 and 2. So this is about this statement. Let's move on to the next. Next is, the Living Planet report is published by A. United Nations Environment Program, B. World Wildlife Fund, C. Greenpeace, D. Convention on Biological Diversity Secretariat. So friends, let me tell you that this report is published by World Wildlife Fund. So it provides a kind of status of wildlife population in the over the earth. So the solution is B. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, some of the long-term results of global warming can be,
First, coastal flooding. Second, increased incidence of tropical diseases. Third, disappearance of some ecological niches. And fourth, disruption of drinking water supplies. Fifth, increased frequency of tropical storms. So, friends, let me tell you that all of these can happen as a result of global warming, because coastal flooding will take place due to melting of glaciers, and also in high temperature, the tropical disease vectors, they can survive to a longer extent, and also there is disappearance of ecological niches, as well as disruption of drinking water supplies and increased frequency of tropical storms. All of these are correct, so the solution would be D, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So the solution is D. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, consider the following about the Comprehensive Environmental Pollution Index. First, it has been developed by Central Pollution Control Board. Second, the index is a rational number to characterize the environmental quality at a given location. Three, the index is used to earmark buffer zones around protected areas using different color schemes. So we have to consider the statements about this Comprehensive Environment Pollution Index. Let me tell you, friends, that yes, it is published by Central Pollution Control Board, and it is a rational number to characterize the environment quality of a given location. But third is not correct. So only 1 and 2 is correct. So the answer would be B. That is 1 and 2 only. So this is correct. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, Napier paragrass and water hyacinth are plants helpful in A, fracking of shale gas, B, metal finishing, C, wastewater treatment, D, pest management in large farms. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you, friend, that this helps in your wastewater treatment. These plant species help in wastewater treatment. And let's move on to the next question. Next question is, under the Forest Rights Act, the authority to initiate the process for determining the nature and extent of individual or community forest rights is A, Gram Sabha, B, District Collector, C, Forest Range Officer, D, District Level Committee. So we have to choose that which of these is responsible for initiating the process for determining the individual or community forest rights. Friends, let me tell you that initiative is taken by the Gram Sabha, but the final approval is given by the District Collector. So the answer would be A, that is initiation of the process of recognition of forest rights, community forest rights or individual forest rights is done by this Gram Sabha. So the solution is A. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, the fundamental arguments of environmental determinists are that, first, physical environment predisposes human social development towards particular trajectories. Second, cultural evolution of a society is decided entirely by social conditions and the ethical disposition. So we have to choose that which of these is correct. Let me tell you, friends, that these environmental determinism says that it is the physical environment, mainly the climate, that influences the social development and guides it towards particular trajectory. So the answer would be A. Let's move on to the next question. 10th is, the rare Indian wild orange is considered to be one of the most primitive citrus fruits in the world. It can be found in India in A, Meghalaya and Manipur, B, Rajasthan and Gujarat, C, Kerala and Tamil Nadu, D, Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you, friends, that this rare Indian wild orange is found in basically Meghalaya and Manipur. So initially it was found in Meghalaya in Garo Hills, but it is now also found in Manipur in a small remote village. So the answer is A. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. If you like the questions, if you like the video, then do hit a like, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And also do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important notifications regarding the updates that we do on our channel. And also, friends, in case you want to get the explanation PDFs, you can contact us at this email ID, that is gys21@gmail.com, or at this contact number, that is 8968426481. So certainly, as I have told you, there will be a minimum cost, and that has been kept for the purpose of your affordability as well as for the purpose of our motivation. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. Thank you. Have a very nice day.